Hello guys, good morning. I'm so happy you're here. It's very early, it's even dark outside, but I couldn't wait because I have something amazing to tell you. I've teamed up with Molly and Olga for over a year now. We collected all our knowledge, all our experiences into one big acrylic pouring course. The course will name Acrylic Pouring A to Z because we cover A to Z. We start with what is acrylic paint, color theory, composition, consistencies, fluid art techniques, varnishing, well, and more. This is gonna be amazing. If I was just starting out or for a couple of months busy and got stuck, and a course like this was online on the market, well, I wouldn't have thought twice to get it. It's coming up next Tuesday, the 15th of December. Make sure you check out our social medias, our Instagram, maybe sign up for our newsletters. We will launch it there as well. This is exciting, really. I can't wait to show you what we made here. But yeah, today, of course, I'm gonna do a pour. I made a color that I really like. It's a rose gold. I'm gonna use it with a gray and a Venetian rose. Whew, I'm so excited, guys, you know. Let's start. Okay, so today I'm gonna make a split color Dutch pour with rose gold and a split in the line. You will see when I do it. So the base will be a Venetian rose and a light gray. And I mix this beautiful rose gold with rose, some copper and some gold. So let's start making the base here. Okay, let's blow that out. Okay, so the base is on, the sides are pretty and neat. And what I meant with the split within the line is that I will pour here first some black and then stop here in the middle. Then I will pour here some white. Like that. I think I will do everywhere a gold. And I have this rose gold. I need to do that everywhere. But must be pretty. I will pour here some of the gray so I can really let it flow. And then on top the Venetian rose. Let's take the blow dryer and blow the base color over the colors. You see all those cells already. Man, that's insane. Okay, I will start here from the middle and blowing that out. All right, that's looking good so far. But you guys know I always retweak the design. This part is just stunning there. And I try to make the sides more soft. I do love this part here. Here it gets a little messy and on top there as well, and here too. Yeah, I do think this looks very nice. The colors will dry so beautiful, I know already, because I made a bunch of these paintings, except with the rose gold. I will show you that later. Some cells are kind of messy. You know what I can do? I can use, of course, the palette knife. here, the cells are not so neat, so I will see if I can swipe this. Oh, my hand is shaking. Why is this? Because it's so early in the morning, probably. Okay, well, that does look prettier. But my hand is shaking way too much to use the palette knife. I'm shaking. No, that's not a good idea. Okay. Normally I have a very steady hand. Not this morning. All right. Well, I guess I'm done then, because otherwise I will probably do way too much. I will give you a close-up and you can see the end result here. Okay, so here she is. I really love the result. These colors work perfect. And this color you see here, that's the rose gold. So I'm super curious how that will dry and if you will see the metallic shine, because now it sort of blends in into the Venetian rose. I always post my dry results on my Instagram and Facebook, so you can check them out there. And of course, we will launch as well our course there. So keep in mind, Tuesday, the 15th of December, we're gonna go live and you'll see it on our other social media first. Okay, guys, well, have a great Sunday. I hope to see you and speak to you on Tuesday. Yeah, bye-bye.